new lecture series of design of structure, which will be offered in GTU semester 5th. So I heartily welcome to all of you in this new series of design of structure. So in this design of structure, the subject is divided into the two parts. First one is design of RCC element and second one is design of steel elements. So it's a combination of RCC and steel. So in first of all, we covered the steel structure portion, which is started with this. What is the introduction and overview of IS 800-2007 and design philosophy. So in this first lecture, we will discuss about what is the introduction of IS 800, why it's needed to design a steel, and what is the design philosophy occurs after the revision of IS 800-2007. So code of standards and provides the specification and stipulation for the state of art and design to be put into the practice. Why code should be needed? So it should be a create a code of standard, provide of specification and the state of art to design put into the practice. So anywhere of India or anywhere of any cities, we can design a steel structure that standard and specifies should be fixed. So there are the no changing in this particular standard and specification described in our IS 800. So the codes and standards of steel design must be understandable, shall be based on good structural theory, shall be deal with elastic instability and dynamics law, and most importance is fatigue age while we design a steel structure. So the IS 800, the basic code of design of steel structure. So the code was revised in the year of 2007 and available since February 2008, after releasing of this documents process. So earlier version of this code was much outdated and compared to recent development in steel design all over the world. So the out of date in the sense, the older code are not described a more provision related to steel structure. Nowadays the world is moved towards the steel structure because the high rise building is needed due to the shortage of land available in our earth. So steel structure nowadays is the best option for the high rise building, and that's why the code should be revised on 2007. What should be the change in revision, that should be seen in our next series. So the earliest IS 800 was based on allowable stress design methodology. So the methodology of this design of steel structure has undergone the major changes during the last two decades due to the research and all over the world. So the revision of many of the steel related code in India are also depend on the revision of IS 800, because this is the main code of steel structure, IS 800. If IS 800 is revised, then lots of code depend on this IS 800 are revised as per the revision of 2007. So an outdated code is determinant of very purpose of the code of practice itself. Thus, the revision of IS 800 was initially to include the design simulation as are prevented all over the world and ensure the availability of efficient structure. So this revision must be done by the time of day. The research should be carried out in steel, and the design simulation are prevented all over the world, and we will design an effective section to provide for resisting any kind of load particular steel structure is designed. So almost all the country are adopted more efficient techniques of design based on various efficient codes. So the current practice all over the world is based on limit state method, or you can say the load and resistance factor design method. So all country are already adopted this method, but we are adopted after the revision of 2007. Before that, we have to use working stress method. So country wise practice of design procedures is given in this table, that already they have done by this LSM, means limit state method. You can see that in table 1, Australia, Canada, China, Europe, UK and Japan already are designed under the limited method. USA also load and resisting factor method or allowable stress method. In India, we are use allowable stress method. That's why we get the revision of 2007 of main IS 800. So other related standard, you can see that after the revision of IS 800, first we will revise IS 801. It's nothing but the code of practice for use of cold form light gauge steel structure member and in general building construction. Then after IS 806, code of practice using steel tubes in general building construction. IS 808, dimension of hot and roll stone beam, column, channel and angle section are covered in this code. Next one is IS 811, is nothing but cold form light gauge structure steel section. Next IS 1161, specification of steel tube for the structural purpose. And IS 2062 is hot roll low, medium, high tensile steel structures. So these are the sub code that will be used for the special kind of structural element. But our main code is IS 800. In our syllabus is concerned, we have used only IS 800. So the IS 800 code of practice for general construction in steel, that will be discussed in our first slide. So the basic code for the general construction in steel structure, widely used and accepted by the engineer, professional bodies, industry and student of civil engineer. So referred it many other Indian standard covering the design of other special structure like transmission line, tower, steel tank, chimney, beam, soils, etc. structures are should be designed under the standards of this code. So the originally covered the requirement for general buildings construction, subsequently made application to all types of steel structures. So the third revision, as per the IS 800 2007, there are so lots of factor of safety are should be covered, that simulation and effective section design should be covered. So all the parameter that should be done by research, decades of research due to this steel structure, that all are covered in this third revision of IS 800 2007 itself. So the need for the third revision, why we needed for the third revision of IS 800. So the developments in the field of steel structure technology and design, as I said that nowadays high rise building is constructed because the land shortage. So only one option, if we constructed the high-rise building with the effectively load carrying system, then steel structure is beneficial, as well as lots of advantage of steel structure that will be discussed in our next slide. So the incorporation provision that are accordance with the latest design of methodology being practiced. So update and standard to the state of art of steel construction technology, and in the efficiency used to improve the structural steel available, the significance of issue, durability and sustainability must be revised due to need of this current situation. So the structure are fit for purpose in addition to being safe, and most important is uneconomical structures. So the benefit to be derived. Expect in a benefit of implementation of revise of IS 800 for design of steel structure, mainly the four main parameters should be implemented. First and foremost, safety. Second one is reliability. Third one is efficiency. And fourth and most important is economy. Because in older one we adopted the design, the steel structure are very heavier, and that's why it's not economy. But due to these changes of third revision, now a steel structure design it should be a economy. How? That will be seen in our next lecture series also. So the contents of the revision of 2007, and you can see the 1984, it's our older version. You can see the general content, what should be the change. So section 1 general, both the section are the same steel. Section 2 are material, that should be the same. Section 3 are general design requirement, that should be the same. Section 4 are introducing new, is nothing but the method of structural analysis. Section 4 are new one, limited design. section C, you can see that design of tensor member. Here the section 4 is design of tensor member. So in between these two sections should be added. Section 7 is design of compression, that both code are same. Section 8, design of member subjected to bending, here it should be the same. Member subjected to combined force is section 9, that also should be covered in older code. Section 10 is connection, section 8 is also connection, so this section are the same. But again new one is section 11, working stress design. Section 12, design and detailing for earthquake, that should be introducing in newer code, because that earthquake should be occurred in 2001. Next one is, and most important, is fatigue gauge. Section 14 is design assessment by testing also. Section 15, durability. Section 16, fire resistance. That's why I use the picture of fire before the revision of 2007 IS 800. Again, section 17, fabrication and erection. That was most important things in steel structure. So these are the 17 sections are covered in 2007 revision of IS 800. While we discuss about 1984 version, there are only 12 sections. So most of are updated in 2007, that are important of fatigue gauge, assessment by testing, durability, fire resistance, factor of safety, you can say, earthquake module should be added. So there are lots of updated in 2007, and hence now a design should be economy, reliable, and the factor of safety is also more compared to older version. Now what is limit step? Now you can ask, or you can raise your question. First of all, what is a limit step? So the limit step is acceptable limit for the safety and serviceability requirement before the failure occur is called limit step. Now how we'll describe the limit step? So limit step is nothing but it's acceptable limit under three circumstances, which are: first is safety, second one is serviceability, and requirement before failure after the occurs is called limit state method. So in limit state design, we prefer the terms of limit state is rather than failure. So the limit state are state beyond which structure no longer static fibers or performance requirements specify. The limit state are classified under the main two criteria. First one is limit state of strength, and second one is limit state of serviceability. We both are maintained in this new era of the technology is nothing but limit state method. So I think you have to clear the idea about limit state method. Now what should be the highlights, or you can say the difference between working stress method and limit state method? This question are most importantly asked in every exam, or you must be know about the main fundamental of these two method, working stress method and limit state method. So we'll discuss about the first point. Factor of safety for yield stress, allowable stress are less than in Fy in case of working stress method. While in limit state method, partial safety factor for material as well as yield and ultimate state both are covered. So next point is pure elastic approach for analysis of structure under working load. While the working load are converted into the increase and as per the partial safety factor causing to limit state of strength. So we converted the factor of safety in our working load and it should be increased their collapsible limit. So it's nothing called limit state of strength. Next point is yielding of buckling never occur at working load. Now here we increase the limit, that's why the post buckling and post yielding play important role in estimating the capacity of structural element at limit state. Here the limit state is nothing but the failure. So rather than the failure, we use the word of limit state. Next point is deformation are evaluated at working loads, while the deformation are evaluated in working loads limit state also. So these are the main key point that should be a different in working state and limit state. Now should we go for the classification of cross section. So the structural element in axial compression, bending compression tend to the buckle or prior holding. To avoid these elements of cross section such as width and flange, or you can say depth of web of eye channel and width and leg of different angle section, T section, width of height of box section needed to be proportionate in a relation with thickness of element of section, and that's why it should be a good etiquette to resist this limited strength. So the table of classification show the three distance varieties of cross section, such as plastic, compact and semi compact, and this table is given in our IS 800. So there are the mainly under the cross varieties of plastic, compact, semi compact section. So section in which width of thickness ratio exceeds to the limiting of semi compact section is known as slender ratio, and the section R is to be avoided. The slender section, if at all used, need to ignore the excess area to arrive at the effective cross section as semi compact section. If two element of cross section fell under two different classification, like one section is under classified as a compact and second one is classified as a semi compact, then the section is classified into most unfavorable classification done by this table, and the table is to be very much described in our IS 800. So what are the element are used as a cross section? First one, you can see that rolled beam of column, it should be shaped by I. Here the vertical member is called web and the horizontal member is called flange. So there are made up with two flange and one web section is nothing but I section. Second one is our rolled channel section. Why we use word rolled channel section? Because it already cast in our factory, we have to use the ready-made rolled section. So channel section, you can also see there are the two flange and one web section. Second one is rectangular or hollow section. Third one is circular section. Second and most important, we have used as a single angle. So it should be shape of angle section. That's why that should be used in a single angle section. Again, there are the two types, equal section and unequal. If D and B both sides are equal, then it should be an equal section. If D and B are not equal, then it should be an unequal section of angle. Next one is our T section. Again, you can see that there are only one flange and one web are should be made up. Next one is double angle back to back. Either you should be built up with two angle back to back and built with composite section. Out of this all section, the economy and balance section is our I section, because there are the two flange and one web. So the flange should be transferred the load on web, and again web should be transferred to the flange. So that's are the balancing load transferring system. That's why the I is very balancing and economy section as the classification is done. So there are the lots of another section. You can see that you can also build I with the two plat of three plat of combination and through welding over there. Also you can build up section with your design requirement. Again, T with component of internal element width, external element width. So these are the elements of cross section. Now, flexural member performance using section classification. So as per the moment is concerned, there are the four section classifiers there. First one, you can see that if M is less than our MI, means yield moment, then section is classified under slender. You can see that. First one, this is the slender column, because your M resisting of moment should be less than of M1. Is your M should be maintained with the MY, it means yield moment. So our section is under semi compact. You can see that. If our moment should be beyond the MY, it means our moment should be stat beyond the yield moment, then our section is compact. You can see that. But our M should be beyond the MY and it should be reached up to the plastic moment, then our moment is should be converted into the plastic moment and section is plastic section. And this capacity, you can say that rotational capacity of section. So these are the four way our section is classified: slender, semi compact, compact and plastic. So these are the four stage we will classify, or any section we can use for the steel structure. So next we will describe about the what are the classification done and how it should be possible. So if we example of I section, you can see that width of flange B is denoted, depth of web D is denoted, thickness of web T is denoted, again thickness of flange T is denoted. So here epsilon is nothing but under root of 250 by Fy. If our steel grade is 250, then in case of 250 Fy, our epsilon should be 1. Now you can see that we will first ratio of B by T. So if the ratio of B by T less than 15.7, then our section should be slender. If our B by T ratio greater than 15.7 and should be less than 15.7 and greater than 10.5, then our section is semi-compact. Our B by T ratio less than 10.5 but greater than or equal to 9.5, then compact. And if our ratio of B by T less than 9.4, then our section should be under plastic. Again, same criteria should be conducted by web also. For the web, we will take the ratio of D by T. If D by T greater than 126, then our section is under slender ratio. Then our D by T less than 126 but greater than 105, then our section is semi-compact. Same way, our D by T ratio less than 105 but greater than or equal to 84, then section is compact. If D by T ratio greater than 84, then our section should be plastic. So likewise, we have to divide the section type, either our section is slender, semi-compact and plastic. So these are the basic steel phenomena occur and what should be the effect in our section. So these are the main thing and what should be the IS 800, why we use in a steel structure. Now we also describe or discuss about what is the advantage of steel structure, why we needed or why we studied in design of structure. So the advantage of steel structure, I say steel offer, you also must be write down because these are the very important points. So write down for the advantage of steel structure. First one is steel offer much better and compressive tensile stress compared to concrete. So steel structure is much better to resist the compressive and tensile stress both compared to concrete structure. Second one, it should be a lighter construction. Third one, unlike the masonry of reinforced concrete, steel can be easily recycled in the environment friendly also. Third one, for erection is faster because there are the no waiting for curing etc. Then prefabrication and demo stability is also compared to concrete is high. The connection using welding, bolting, riveting can be done by easily. Structural steel is used in load bearing frame in a building, truss member, bridge etc. So it has a high ductility which enable to withstand of expensive deformation without failure, and thus it is more safer against sudden load and overloading. So in case of sudden load is concerned, like factory or heavy equipment should be lifted, or you can say the overloading when it stands to our calculation is wrong and load should be over, that time steel is very useful, means beneficial. So some advantages also there. So there are the some disadvantage of steel structure also there. These are the disadvantages. First one, if structure are fire protected, the strength of reduce under high temperatures. Second one, if the requirement of corrosion is protected, so corrosion should be done in steel, so we must be protected that corrosion process. In steel building, cladding and dividing hole are made up by many stories of other materials, that it should be divided into the separation of wall. Then fourth disadvantage is often a concrete foundation is provided, so we must be provided our foundation is concrete, so that foundation and our base plate are very key role to join this foundation level. Next is welding is tightening of high strength fabrication grip bolt require the proper training. So welding and bolting is required high and proper training skill work. If many case cost of steel structure work out of more than concrete structure. So in many case in our high rise building also it should be cost should be compared to high of concrete structure, because we use a heavier section in steel for resisting this overloading and you can say the fluctuate load. That's why it should be more. But the advantage that will be covered, there are more, and that's why the steel is nowadays a very trend material to use as a construction. So these are the all about the advantage and disadvantage. Why plastic is to be analysis, or you can say the introduction in IS 800. So the main concept of plastic analysis of steel structure is the exploration of reverse strength of steel material beyond the elastic limit. Because we have introducing the limit state, it means we beyond the yield state. So if the load is released, now it should be become in a elastic limit. So at that time, what should be the reversible stress or should be resist? That's why we introducing the plastic modulus. You can see in our case of stress strain curve, first year most, the same principle should be applicable over there. So the typical stress strain curve for steel under uniaxial tensor indicate the presence of upper and lower limit of yield point. But the plastic region, wherever or without increase in strain, it should be strain rapidly increased. The strain hardening and finally the material physically fail by reaching the ultimate stress by creating these fractures. So this limit should be overcome. That's why we should introducing the plastic state in our material for the region of this IS 800. So in idealized, the stress strain relation of mild steel in upper lower yield points are considered to be the same, but in the plasticity due to the yielding of material start just after the yield stress is reached. So directly it should be start after the yield stress should be reached. So the effect of this strain hardening is ignored, and that's why we use the plastic. So the stress strain curve consists only the two parts. Which one? First one is elastic range by straight line variation up to the yield stress, and second one is horizontal line indicating the plastic range having the constant value of yield stress. So now the requirement of plastic analysis as per the IS 800. What are the requirement in the third revision done by the 2007? So indicate the ductility and plastic rotation capacity of cross section. Second one is stress strain characteristic should be compliant with IS 2062. Third and most important is stress strain curve shall have platinum at yield strength extending for at least 6 times of yield strength. So there are the 6 times strength capacity should be increased. Fourth one, the ratio of tensile strength to the yield strength shall not be less than 1.2 times. Please keep that mind. It's most of the questions should be asked in our practical Viva also. The ratio of tensile strength to the yield strength shall not be less than 1.2. Fifth one, the elongation of gauge length shall not be less than 15% of steel must be exhibit the strain hardening capacity. Sixth one, the structural member use shall be hot rolled and fabricated from hot roll press as a section. The cross section of the member not continuously plastic hinge should be at least that compact the classification. So all our section are not designed in a plastic. We have to use plastic hinge for the compact classification. So when the plastic hinge occur in a member, the proportion of its cross section should be exist the limit value of plastic classification. Next one is cross section should be symmetrical. What should about the symmetrical? So its axis perpendicular to the axis of plastic hinge should be rotation. And last, at the plastic collapse, there are the sufficient number of plastic hinge developed in a structure. So, as the transformer into the mechanism of this plastic state. So, these are the 10 points. That's why we plastic should be introduced. So, for that, these 10 points are introducing the plastic. So, these are the nothing about the what are the plastic code are used, what are the design philosophy that would be covered in IS 800, and most important of this lecture is why we introducing the IS 800 in 2007 and what are the design philosophy that should be used in our steel structure. So this all about this topic. Thank you students. In next lecture we will more discuss about design philosophy in steel structure and what are the cordial provision should be used in our steel structure. And later on we will start our first module is nothing but bolted connection. Thank you friends for listening this series. Please subscribe my YouTube channel for updating for and notification for new lecture for the same series is design of structure. It will be introducing in semester 5. Thank you friends for listening the my video.